Hello guys, in this video we'll talk about IES lights. What is it, where to find it, and how to use it in Corona and Viri. IES stands for Illuminating Engineering Society. It is a file format used for describing the distribution of light from a light source. Many manufacturers provide this type of data so that designers can simulate how the project will look in reality when a specific light source is used. But we also can use these files in our projects. Just the file doesn't say much though. We need the visual representation of this to make it easily usable. Otherwise, we would have to test each file one by one to see the results. You can find many of these files online. There are plenty of free IES files. You can Google for some generic examples, or you can look for a specific one on the manufacturer's website like Aircro. As an example, on this website, you can look for a specific lamp, for example, depending on the place where it is mounted. And you'll get the list of lamps that match the criteria. As you find the one you want, you can choose the type of illumination. When you choose a specific lamp, you'll find the image that represents the distribution of the light from this. And at the bottom, you'll find the IES file that you can download. You can also use IESlibrary.com website, which has more than 307k IES files collected from different manufacturers. On this website, you can look for the IES files by choosing a specific manufacturer. You can also choose tags to get more precise results. The big advantage of this website is that you can see the visual example of the IES file, which is not always the case on the manufacturer's websites. It makes searching way easier. Well, as we know what IES is, and we know how to find it, now it's time to learn how to use it. Let's start with Corona. The scene I will be working on today comes from our visualization training. You will find the link to it in the corner. I've placed a pendant light in the scene from my library so we can easily imitate the light from this. Go to Lights and choose Corona light. Create a light. I need to rotate it though. We can position it somewhere in the center. And I will move it to the left as well. Okay, now go to the Modify tab. We'll work with this last panel here, IES. We need to click None and choose the IES file we want to use. In Corona, we have a couple of files that come with the software. Let's try the first one. Okay, we can start interactive rendering to see what effect we'll get. Here we go. We can see the interesting effect on the wall. It gives us a specific shape. If we turn off IES, we'll get the default, sphere in my case, shape. Thanks to IES files, we can achieve different sorts of shapes. We can try a more focused one, for instance. You can notice, this one is more pointed. It will work great to highlight a specific object in the scene. Let's try one more. This time something wider and soft. It definitely doesn't look realistic with this type of lamp, but the effect is as described. We can of course use the other files, not just the one from Corona. We just need to choose the desired file. I will use something from my library to show you this as an example. Okay, this one is soft and has a nice simple shape. It is quite universal. It is too much guesswork though to look for the desired effect. I recommend using some software that makes it possible to see the results of the file as a picture. I always use the Project Manager for this. You'll find the link to the plugin in the description below the video. So this one represents the IES file I just chose. You can see that it's pretty close to what we've achieved in the scene. There are endless examples you can use. Anyway, I can show you one more effect. Also, IES lights work the same as normal lights. So for example, if we want to have the effect to be stronger on the wall, we need to move it closer to it. This way, the shape is way more visible, sharper, and clear. We can use other options, the same as with normal light. We can, for example, change the intensity and make it more or less intense. If you wish, you're able to change the light color. You can also use the Kelvin scale. The non-physical properties can be used with the IES lights as well. Now let's jump to Viri, the The method is pretty similar here. If we want to add the IES file, we need to add Vira IES. Then, click here and choose the file you want to use. This time, I will use the file we have downloaded from the ERCO website so you can see how it works. Here we go. Similarly in V-Ray, we can adjust the intensity, for example, or its color. We can also use the Kelvin scale by choosing the temperature option. We can move the target if we wish. By the way, in Corona, you can also turn on the target option. We can control how sharp the effect is by changing the distance between the wall and the light. Here, I would suggest watching my video, The Fundamentals of Lighting, if you haven't already, so you understand what are the characteristics of the light. We can use the other options like rotation, for example. Or exclude and include objects that are influenced by this light. If you want to learn how to create outstanding images from start to finish, join our visualization training. Also, watch my other videos about lighting. Here are my suggestions. Bye-bye!